Hello, this is Victor. I'm here with a new weekly, and this time we are going to paint, for this weekly painting, a dog. Okay, we have this dog from the Rock Trader set. I wanted to paint it for a while, and now it's time to give a paint. So we are going to start applying rhino's hide. Okay, on all the fur. This dog is wearing an armor. He or she, I don't know if it's. And we're going to apply this first on the whole body, okay? So we do a layer of rhino's hide very consistently, and then I will be back for the next step, okay? So I do that and I'm back. Okay, next step, I'm going to use Fenrisian gray to do the armor, as I'm doing for all the guys, okay? Like this one, because it goes together with the rest of the guys. It seems that they have money to put an armor on the dog. So we are going to apply the same color. So this is not important, just the same color that you use for the rest of your guys, okay? So I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to do that and I'm back. Okay, next I'm going to apply Aguacer shade, Noon oil over the dog, over all the brown, okay? So it will avoid the armor parts, but as we want to make this color darker, okay? I just did the brown to have this brown highlight on the black. But normally these Doberman are more on the black than on the brown. So I'm going to do that, and I'm back once it had dry. Okay, next step, I'm going to use Scrag Brown, okay? And we're going to apply this one on some parts that normally the Doberman have in a lighter brown. So we are going to apply it inside of the ears. Okay, I have a picture of a Doberman on the screen of my computer to help me to know where I should do that. Then we're going to do the same on the other one. This one, it's quite common, and the other one that is very common on the Doberman is this part of the muzzle. We have to leave the nose black and the upper black too, but then we do the under jaw, that color, and you can go a little bit, yeah, it goes almost to the eye zone, it goes like that, okay. So something like that. You can go back, more back or less, depending on the test. You have to ensure that the rim of the full mouth, it's in this brown. Shape to this. Okay, and then here I will give a little bit of shape as well. The next part that they have light brown is sometimes the breasts, but here we have belts and armor, so I will not go too much there. But the inner side of the legs and the bottom of the legs, they are round. So we are going to do the same, but the, yeah, you can do it like if he's wearing socks. Okay, so you can start from here. Later on we are going to do a Y, so we are going to make this darker at the bottom. And you go almost to half leg. It's important to have this picture of the dog that you want to imitate, because sometimes we do it by memory, but yeah, I cannot remember by heart how all the dogs look like, right? So it's good to have some reference in front of you so you can follow. And we're going to do the same on the leg. You can go higher or lower. I also think that the back legs normally are lower and more on the insides. For example, what we can do here is they still have, we can do something like that and go more on the inside. Something like that, and don't do too much on the outside of the leg. Just keep it like that, and we just close it. I will repeat the same on the other side, and I'm back for the next step. Okay, next step I'm going to use with charger contrast, and we are going to apply this on the armor. Okay. So this is how I do the color of the armor on my, on these guys, okay? Here we go. This one. This one. And the one at the belly. And I will wait that this dries, because I want to do first the belts, and once the belts are done we are going to do the highlights. But you can see that it's looking quite nice. So we can do one thing, just let me, sorry if I change my mind, but we are going to apply Aguax Airshade where we have applied the light brown now. Okay, so a little bit, because this will help me to soak some shading where we have applied, especially on the mouth. We want to have again the line of the mouth. Try not to put too much, I don't want to darken too much, but here for example on the pose I want to have again the toes shaded. And as you can see, I don't try to play too much, okay? So now I will wait at all this dries and I'm back. Okay, next step. In order to have contrast, I'm going to use a gray, Administratum gray, or Downstone is the one I want. And we are going to do the different belts that are used to to attach this armor to the dog, okay? Okay, so we are going to do all this, and I decided to use the Anna Gray if it's, because this can be made of any synthetic polymer, this type of things, okay? Belts. I decided to use at the end gray to have more contrast with the rest of the paint job. Okay, so I'm going to do this. I will also go over the the different things. At the end this will not be metallic, we'll make that like a synthetic plastic, something like that, all these things. Except the ones at the bottom, this is quite tricky to reach. But okay, I will do this and I'm back for the next step. Next step, I'm going to use the messy desert and I'm going to do the armor trimming. Okay, this part. Okay, I'll do this. And I will do as well, I know that this is for to attach the belt, but I will do these ones as well. Because this is quite like that. So I will do this and I'm back for the next step. Okay, next step, I'm going to do a couple of washes, so I'm going to use Seraphine Sepia, this one, okay, on the yellowish ornament. Take another brush, this is not good. Check it a little bit more. Okay. Now I'm going to take noon oil and put it on the different bell sections of the this thing. Good. And now what I'm going to do, I'm going to use a rhino's hide. Okay, put a little bit more rhino's hide. There's one. And I'm going to use more from brown. Yes. I need to start up some new part. And we are going to highlight some parts of the dolly. Okay, we start with the rhino's hide. I try not to go too much. I don't want to exaggerate too much the highlight. I want to keep the dark look, but a little bit. Want to show a little bit the shine. I went for quite dark browns, and I will not go, I will try not to go lighter. Then inside of the ears, or on the ears, I will use the Messy Desert, very thin. Over here on the mouth. I will use the same squat brown. To make the brown a little bit more. I wanted to make it a little bit brighter, this brown. What I want to do. That it went too dark, to add a little, to make a little bit more. Okay. Now we keep the work with the Reynolds height. We'll change the brush. Using very little more from ground to help to highlight a little bit some parts. If I go too much, then I come back with Reynolds height next to it. So I don't want to look too brown, I want it to look it that it's looking quite dark. Okay. And I will use even black needed in some parts. Okay. So if I need a dark shade, I will use black. Make a bright point. Here's one. And the eyes, I will put white, but most of the white. And the white is just to make the reflection, because you want to keep most of the eye dark brown or black. Go like that. Like that. Now I have them one too low and one too high. This is a big mistake. I need to move one eye up. Now it's good. And now I need to first use black, the one that I went too low. Now we have the two eyes in the same position. And what I do now, I will take the dark brown. I will cover all except a little bit. And you keep it like that. Okay, maybe it's not that visible, you just keep very little white, that is the reflection of the eye more than the really the eye. Then the tail, we want to put some highlight on the tail. You want to keep it, so you want to pop up the musculature because it's nicely done, the musculature of this dog, but keeping overall quite a dark tone. So this way I'm doing more like a little bit like, it's not edge highlight, but it's almost that. So you try to follow the shape of the musculature, and then just keep a very subtle or thin highlight. So this is that. Okay, I made a big mistake. So, but this is not a problem. You come back with Vesper's Runner's height. And the top of the neck, I want to do a little bit more of highlight. No. Okay, like that. And no, I don't like that. And I will go back to the face, because what you want to have. You can see that it's taking me quite a long to do all the work. I wanted to do in camera so you can see how I work all this. Sorry if the video is a little long. But I wanted to show you exactly how I'm doing all this. You can see what I do is I keep highlighting different parts until I'm happy how the different texture, different musculature, sorry, and parts of the dog are visible, okay. But I don't like here this super light, this dot there, and then like a bit here. And it's, I can scale it a bit more the highlight. And I will go again on the neck. Do like that. And I think like that. Will be good enough. Okay. think like that we have a nice looking dog. Now I can, here I want to make it thinner. Maybe this one. There's some auto-oxygenated, no, I can clean up a little bit. But I think I'm quite happy now how it looks like. Okay. Next step, I'm going to use flake one flesh. And we are going to highlight a little bit the yellow ornament. Look it like that. And I'm going to take a very light gray. I think at the end I will keep it, if this is not really metal system, is made of prefer. The one I got for my, not the armor, but the harness I got for my dog is not, have not metallic buckles or closings. So it's just keep it like that. And then I will use to do some highlight. And we'll take darker gray. Clean up here and do it like that. This, I think it's rust gray. This is rust gray. I have it in my palette. So I will with that, I think we are going to be ready. That's all for today, for this week. So how I do the dog from the Rock Trader. So I think it's a nice miniature, something different that we normally don't do, this type of creature or animals. Okay, we don't have too many dogs in Warhammer, and I think it's a nice thing to do. So I hope you have enjoyed this one. Please give a like if you have liked. Let me know what do you think. And as usual, thanks a lot for watching, and see you again later. Bye.